Hello friends, I am Sushant Raghavan. Welcome to Technical and Quality session. For understanding the technical requirements and quality standards in clothing industry, making a sustainable garment, I have good practical experience in the apparel manufacturing sector. My skills are CAD pattern making, sample development, technical requirements, and measuring quality performance. Today's session is about sewing thread construction in clothing industry. For more sessions like this, do like and subscribe to my channel. Now let's begin the presentation. Thread construction. The creation of sewing threads from the natural and man-made fibers already described can take a variety of forms, where the fibers occur naturally in short lengths or have been cut or broken into short lengths. They must be twisted together initially into a single yarn, and then that twist must be balanced by applying a reverse twist, as two or three such yarns are combined to form the thread construction. The twist in the single yarn consolidates the strength and flexibility provided by the fibers themselves. Without the reverse twist, known as finishing twist, a conventional thread could not be controlled during sewing. Thread twist. Twist is defined as the number of turns inserted per cm of yarn or thread produced. If the twist is too low, the yarns may freak and break. If too high, the resulting liveliness in the thread may cause knurling, loop knots, or slippage from the packaged thread. There are two possibilities of twist direction as shown in figure, Z and S direction. Thread twist. The fractional force acting on a thread during its passage through a sewing machine also tends to insert some twist, predominantly in one direction. In a lock stitch machine, during normal straight sewing, the needle and hook tend to insert some Z-twist to the sewing thread. A thread with a correctly balanced finishing twist reaches equilibrium as it resists further tightening up of the twist. A thread with an S-twist becomes untwisted by the action of the machine and then frays and breaks. Because the lock stitch machine type is the most severe in its handling of the thread, the majority of threads intended for use in machine sewing are constructed with a finishing Z-twist. There are only a few machines such as Flatlock for which this is not suitable, and special threads with S-finishing twist are available for this. Monofilament. When threads are made directly from continuous filaments as in polyester and polyamide, a wide variety of different constructions is possible. The very simplest is hardly a thread at all, being just one filament of polyamide of a larger size than normal. It is called monofilament and is only of limited use. It is harsh on the machine and rather inflexible because of the cross-sectional shape never varies as it would with multifilament. In addition, the cut ends are harsh on the wearer. It has virtually no seam grip and stitch tend to unravel easily. Its great advantage is a transparency which reduces the need for shade matching, and the three tones of natural light and dark grey adopt to suit the limited range of application for which the thread is suited. It tends to be used for blind filling and overedging at the lower quality end of clothing manufacturing and for furnishing and household textiles. Multifilament thread. Other types of thread which are made from continuous filaments of polyester and polyamide are those generally classed as textured. Texturing is a term used to describe modifications obtained by various means to the appearance and surface characteristics of straight synthetic filament yarns. In fine sizes, these threads are useful as needle threads in overedge and chain stitch machines, but their commonest use is in larger sizes where their soft handle and spreading properties provide good seam cover when used in the loopers of overedge and cover stitch machines. With appropriate stitch size and thread tensions, almost complete cover of the fabric can be achieved, which adds greatly to comfort in garments worn next to the skin and to appearance in the fabric which frays badly. The degree of stretch in these threads can also be used when a fabric of moderate stretch must be sewn with a lock stitch, and in this case they are used in the bobbin. Coarse spun thread. Yet another fundamentally different type of thread construction is that known as coarse spun. where a continuous multifilament core is wrapped around a sheet of spun fibers, two or three of these yarns then being plied together. That can be a mixture of natural and synthetic fibers. The majority of these core spun threads consist of a polyester core and a cotton cover. A major objective was to create a thread which did not suffer damage on contact with a needle heated by friction against the fabric, and the cotton cover fulfills this function extremely well. A difficulty with the polyester and cotton combination is the thread must be dyed twice, and this adds to cost. Poly-poly core spun thread. Many of the advantages of core spun construction are now being achieved in threads which are poly-poly core spun. That is a polyester filament core with a spun polyester covering, and these do not need the double dyeing process. There is also a strength contribution from the polyester sheet which is not obtained with cotton, although with the type of high tenacity polyester used for the core of these threads, strength is already very high. Suitability remains at least as important as strength, and the cotton cover may continue to give this more successfully. Core spun threads in general enable clothing manufacturers to sew with finer threads and still achieve adequate seam strength. This is an important advantage with fine fabrics, because the finer the thread, the less it will tend to cause pucker in the fabric. This also matches up with the use of finer needles to reduce needle damage. Thread finishes. The requirement of a lubricating finish applied to a sewing thread is that it should produce a regular level of friction, and that for synthetic threads in particular, it should provide protection from needle heat. Without a controlled amount of lubrication applied to threads, unacceptable damage would be inflicted on them during the sewing process, which would result in thread breaks during sewing and seam breakdown in wear. A lubricant must not clog the needle eye nor cause staining. It must allow the thread to unwind evenly from the package, and it must reduce friction with machine surfaces but without creating too much slippage. Thread finishes. In sewing flame retardant fabrics, thermoplastic thread must be used, and 100% polyester is the only one recommended, as it shrinks away from the flame and does not support combustion. In sewing chemically treated fabric, the seam would probably be extinguished regardless of its fiber type by the deoxygenating gases which the fabric releases when burnt. But it would seem sensible to aim for the highest standard of fire resistance possible by using spun polyester thread for sewing all night wear. Thread finishes. Another special demand is for threads with a water resistant finish. Sewing waterproof or water repellent clothing creates difficulty along the seam, which tends to allow water to enter the garment. Matching of fabric and thread finish, which is sometimes needed, is in the area of soil release. Much workwear fabric is treated with a soil release finish, and unless the thread is similarly treated, the dirt washed of the fabric is redeposited on the seams, thus spoiling the appearance of the garment. A soil release finish is now available on some spun polyester and polyester and cotton core spun threads. Thank you for watching. For more sessions like this, do like and subscribe to my channel. Please comment your valuable thoughts, and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified when I post a new presentation. Bye, have a good day.